Recently on Netflix came the Meltdown series about the accident at the Three Mile Island nuclear power plant. The series is called Documentary. TMI accident is the most serious accident in the history of U.S. commercial nuclear power plants. The Three Mile Island Unit 2 reactor near Middletown, Pennsylvania partially melted on March 28, 1979, releasing radioactivity into the environment. Based on the trailer for Meltdown, it's about an incredibly horrific accident. The atmosphere of the trailer is filled with horror and a story about the terrible consequences for residents in the form of cancer. Perhaps the creators of the Netflix series were inspired by the success of competitors from HBO, who released the Chernobyl series 3 years ago. Chernobyl was a huge success and was really saturated with the atmosphere of fear and horror, the atmosphere of the Soviet era, which was also noted by the witnesses of those events. However, it is important to understand a few things about the atomic component specifically. It is this component that is most often distorted in works of pop culture and cinema, and neither the Chernobyl series, nor, apparently, the Meltdown series escaped it. This is a significant excess of the real danger of radiation and nuclear energy. If Chernobyl was indeed the world's worst nuclear power plant accident, in which more than 130 people died, more than 100,000 were displaced, and the expected estimate of premature deaths from cancer is about 4,000. Then the Three Mile Island accident was the worst nuclear power plant accident in United States, but no one died as a result. Moreover, no one received high and dangerous doses of radiation. The population around the station received a dose of 10 microsieverts, which is several times less than the dose from a chest X-ray and hundreds of times lower than the usual dose received by the inhabitants of this area in a year. No increased incidence of cancer around the station has been found decades later. And this is the result of the most dangerous incident at a nuclear power plant in the United States. It is worth adding that even the accident at the Japanese nuclear power plant Fukushima, the largest after Chernobyl, was similar in consequences. No one died from radiation, there is no increased cancer. At the same time, about 18,000 people died from the tsunami, but few people remember this, unlike Fukushima. At the same time, the consequences for the U.S. nuclear industry were serious. Of course, the accident revealed a number of shortcomings in the nuclear industry, led to a revision of emergency response, training of reactor operators, human factors engineering, radiation protection and many other areas of nuclear power plant operation. All this has made the nuclear industry more reliable and safer. However, the social effect was much stronger and scarier. It was the fear caused by the accident and the increased influence of anti-nuclear groups that led to the refusal to issue new licenses for the construction of nuclear power plants in the United States for almost 40 years. By the way, both Ukraine and Russia after Chernobyl, and Japan after Fukushima, did not abandon nuclear energy, and after a short pause and revision of safety requirements, they continue to develop it and consider it an important component of their energy balance. In the United States, however, only in recent years has interest in the atom begun to revive in the wake of climate threats and air pollution issues. But these are much more dangerous things. About 50,000 people die every year in the United States alone from air pollution caused by emissions from thermal power plants. And this is partly a consequence of the phasing out of the nuclear industry after the Three Mile Island accident. However, most likely nothing will be said about this in the series, in contrast to the terrible threats of nuclear energy. So, as with the Chernobyl series, of course, it will not be superfluous to watch Meltdown as a piece of fiction that fuels interest in the topic. However, do not think that the status of documentary films makes it objective. The immediate consequences of the accident should be studied on the basis of scientific data and by comparing a number of less artistic sources. Some of them, by the way, will be in the description of the video. Don't forget to like this video and subscribe to the channel. You will find many more interesting news and stories about nuclear energy.